RMS Carpathia was Connaught Line's transatlantic passenger steamship built by Swan Hunter and Wingham Richardson on 10 September 1901. I think you guys must be eager to know about Carpathia's Titanic saving. So, if you have ever checked RMS Carpathia's history, she was famous for her saving of 1912 Titanic disaster. So, let's have a look at it first.
But before we move further, welcome to Leo's Info Space Ship Series 1. Please make sure you have subscribed to our channel because we will be back with some more ship series.
On the night on 14 April, Carpathia's wireless operator Harold Cottam had a missed previous message from the Titanic as he was on a bridge at the time. After his shift ended at the midnight, he continued listening to the transmitter before bed and received a message from the Cape Cod, Massachusetts stating that they had a private traffic from Titanic. He thought it would be helpful like any early morning and at 12:11 a.m. on the night of 15 April sent a message to Titanic stating that Cape Cod had a traffic for them. In reply, he received Titanic's distress signal stating that they had struck an iceberg and were in a need of immediate and urgent assistance. Cottam rushed down to the ladder to captain's cabin and told Captain Arthur Henry Roston, who immediately sprang into action and gave the order to turn the ship around, and then asked Harold Cottam if he was absolutely certain it was a distress signal from the Titanic. Cottam said it was, and Roston ordered its crew to get ready for a rescue procedures. Cottam meanwhile messaged the Titanic that Carpathia is coming as soon as possible. The Carpathia reached at the edge of ice field at 2:45 a.m. and for the next 2 hours dodged iceberg and reached the Titanic non-position at 4 a.m. approximately an hour and a half after Titanic went down. For the next 4 hours, ship took 705 survivors of the disaster from 20 lifeboats. Throughout the rescue, Carpathia's own passengers assisted any way that they could, offer warm food, beverages, blanket, accommodation, etc. By 9 a.m, the last survivor had been picked. Roston gave the order to sail away from the area. For this immediate action of Carpathia and Carpathia's crew, both US government and UK government awarded many medals to the crew, and Roston was also awarded with the Silver Cup and Golden Medal. Background and construction. At the time of 1900, the Connaught Line was facing a tight competition from British White Star Line and German North German Liner. Instead of spending additional money on speed and prestige, targeted on profitability in order to remain solvent enough in the shipping business. The Carpathia was modified design of Ivernia class ships. Like her predecessor, her design was based on a long hull, a low well balanced superstructure. The Carpathia was designed with a single tall smokestack funnel to carry soot and smoke well clear of her passenger area. Her keel was laid down on 10 September 1901 and she was christened by Miss Watson, daughter of vice chairman of Connaught Line, and she underwent her sea trial on voyage from River Tyne to River Mersey between 22 to 25 April. Despite being an intermediate liner designed mainly for second and third class traveler, the Carpathia's interior accommodation were still quite comfortable. The second class liner accommodation also included a walnut panel smoking room and a library at Bridge A deck. After 1905 renovation, these spaces were converted into first class accommodation, and the third class lining saloon extended the full width of the ship and seated 300 passengers, with a wall paneled in polyable oak and a teak dado. Third class also included a smoking room and a ladies' room on upper sea deck. The ventilation system were designed to force fresh air over coiled thermotanks, which could be fed with cool water during winter and steam during summer. Thus, heating and cooling of the ship were good, and the Carpathia made her maiden voyage on 5 May 1903 from Liverpool to Boston, Massachusetts. Even though lacking the speed and grand luxury of express line, it still managed to gain popularity worldwide. And after Carpathia's rescue of Titanic survivor, she was more famous and gained worldwide attention. Service in First World War. During First World War, the Carpathia was used to transfer Canadian and American Expeditionary Force to Europe, at least some of her voyage in convoy, sailing from New York to Liverpool. Sinking and aftermath. On 15 July 1918, the Carpathia departed Liverpool in a convoy bound for Boston, carrying 57 passengers and 166 crew. The convoy travelled on a zigzag course along with an escort in accordance with a procedure against submarine attacks. The escort left the convoy early in the morning of 17 July and the convoy was cut in half. The Carpathia continued west along with 6 other ships, and as the largest in the convoy, she assumed the role of commodore ship. 3.5 hours later, 9:15 a.m, while sailing in the southwest approach, a torpedo was sighted approaching on her port side. The engine were thrown in full, astern and helm was turned hard a starboard, but it was too late to avoid the torpedo. The Carpathia was torpedoed near number 3 hatch of the port side. by the German Imperial Navy submarine U-55, followed by a second which penetrated the engine room, killing 3 firemen, the trimmer, and effectively disabling her ability to escape. As the engine were rendered inoperable by second torpedo impact, the explosion severely damaged Carpathia's electrical gear, including wireless radio apparatus, as well as the two of ship's lifeboat. As a result, Captain William Botero, in command of Carpathia's in 1916, signaled the other ships of convoy to send out wireless message by use of flags. He then had a rocket fired to attract the attention of nearby patrol boats. The remaining convoy steamed away at full speed to elude the submarine. As the Carpathia began to settle by the head and list to port, Captain William Portero gave the order to abandon ship. All passengers and the surviving crew member boarded the 11 lifeboat as the Carpathia sank. There were 218 survivors of 223 aboard. As the passenger and crew disembarked, Portero, the chief officer, first and the second officer, and the gunner remained on the ships, seeing to it that all confidential books and documents were thrown overboard. The captain then signaled one of the lifeboats to come alongside, and he and the remaining crew members abandoned their ships. U-55 surfaced the face and fired a third torpedo into the ship's gunner room, resulting in a massive explosion that doomed the Carpathia. U-55 started approaching the lifeboat when Azela-class sloop HMS Snowdrop arrived in the scene and drove away the submarine with a gunfire, picking up the survivor from the Carpathia around 1 a.m. The Snowdrop arrived back to Liverpool with the survivor on evening of 18 July. The Carpathia was sank at 11 a.m. Discovery and salvage works. On 9 September 1999, her wreck was reported by Reuters and AP Wire Service, and National Underwater and Marine Agency NUMA discovered the wreck at 180 meters of water, but adverse conditions forced his ships to abandon the position before it could be verified by underwater cameras. First, it was determined to be the Hamburg American Line ISIS, sunk on 8 November 1936, but on 2000, NUMA had found a true wreck of the Carpathia on spring of that year at the depth of 155 or 500 meters. After sub-attack, the Carpathia landed upright on the seabed. NUMA gave approximate location of the wreck at 190 km west of Fastnet, Ireland.